Hello friends, myself is Pawar AH from HGM College Karad. In last lecture, we discussed the point which is higher order derivative. Now in this lecture, we discuss the new point which is successive differentiation. So let's start our new point which is successive differentiation or nth order derivative of some standard function. So successive differentiation is the process of differentiating a given function successively for n times, and the result of such a differentiation are called successive derivative. That means y is equal to f of x is a function is given. So if you differentiate first time, again we differentiate second time, again we differentiate third time, up to n times, that type of differentiation are called successive derivative. So there is a no general formula to find nth derivative of a function, because each and every function has its own specified general formula for its nth derivative. Means any function is given and we find the successive differentiation or nth order derivative, there is a no formula for nth order derivative. So but there are algorithms to find it. So how to find nth order derivative? Let's check here. Use the method of mathematical induction whenever is applicable. There is a three step which is helpful finding nth order derivative of any function. So our first step is use simple differentiation to get first, second, third order derivative. Means any function is given and we find the nth order derivative, that time we first differentiate first time, second time, third time. Now your next step is we observe the changes in the coefficient, the angles, the power of function and the sign of each term. Means your second step, we can observe if you differentiate first time, we check any sign is changes, power of function is change, yeah, coefficient change, yeah, angles change. Similarly, second time differentiate, again we check sign are changes, angles changes or power of function changes, yeah, coefficient changes. So second step, we can observe that things. Now, step 3, express the nth derivative with the help of the pattern of a change that you have observed. Means in second step, we observe any changes which can help for the finding nth order derivative. This will be your general formula for the nth derivative of a given standard function. So these three steps which is help for finding nth order derivative for any standard function. So let's start the solution examples based on the nth order derivative. Example, find nth order derivative of following function. Our first function is log of x. So let's start the solution. Let y is equal to log of x, differentiating with respect to x first time. So we get here derivative of y with respect to x is equal to derivative of log of x with respect to x. We know that derivative of log of x is a standard function. So derivative of that function is 1 upon x. So derivative of dy by dx is equal to 1 upon x is equal to this one, we can write minus 1 raised to the power 0 divided by x. Because minus 1 raised to the power 0, answer is 1. So this coefficient 1, we can write 1 upon x. Now, again a differentiating with respect to x, we get here. Derivative of dy by dx with respect to x is equal to derivative of 1 upon x with respect to x. We know that derivative of 1 upon x, which is minus 1 upon x square. So therefore, d2y divided by dx square is equal to minus 1 divided by x square. Now here, this minus 1 we can write minus 1 raised to the power 1 multiply coefficient is 1 divided by x square. Again, a differentiating with respect to x, we get here derivative of d2y divided by dx square with respect to x is equal to minus sign take it outside. Derivative of 1 upon x square with respect to x. We know that derivative of 1 upon x square, which is minus 2 divided by x cube. So here we get here d3y divided by dx cube is equal to minus inside the bracket minus 2 divided by x cube. Now this minus become plus. So we get here 2 upon x cube. Now this we can write, this positive sign we can write minus 1 raised to the power 2 multiply. This 2 we can write 2 multiply 1. This is the coefficient of that term divided by x cube. Now again a differentiating with respect to x, we get here derivative of the 3y divided by dx cube with respect to x is equal to 2 is a constant, take it outside, derivative of 1 upon x cube with respect to x. Now we know that derivative of 1 upon x cube, which is minus 3 divided by x raised to 4. So therefore d4 of y divided by dx raised to 4 is equal to 2 multiply minus 3 multiply 1 upon x raised to 4. So this we can write minus 3 multiply 2 multiply 1 divided by x raised to 4. Now this minus sign we can write here minus 1 raised to the power 3 multiply 3 multiply 2 multiply 1 divided by x raised to 4. So here first step is completed. We can given function differentiate 4 times. Now we observe here, if you differentiate first time, the sign of function which is plus and power of x is 1. Again I differentiate second time, then sign here changes, minus sign, then after power of x is 2. Again a differentiate with respect to x, that time again sign is changes is plus, coefficient we get 2 and power of x is 3. Again a differentiate fourth time, that time sign is changes, minus, coefficient is 3 multiply 2 multiply 1 and power of x is 4. So here observe that when you differentiate fourth time, here minus 1 power is 3, means it is reduced by 1, and this coefficient is reduced by 1, which is here 4 number, so here 3 number, means reduced by 1. Now here x power is 4, that means whatever differentiate in first time power is 1, differentiate second time power of x is 2, third time power of x is 3, fourth time power of x is 2, x is 4. So if you differentiate n times, so x power is n. So in general nth derivative is dn of y divided by dx raised to n is equal to minus 1 raised to the power n minus 1 multiply n minus 1 multiply n minus 2 up to 3 multiply 2 multiply 1 divided by x raised to n. This is known as n minus 1 factorial. So nth order derivative is equal to minus 1 raised to the power n minus 1 multiply n minus 1 factorial divided by x raised to n. This is our final answer. Now we see here next example, e raised to ax plus b. So we find the nth order derivative of this function. So let's start the solution. Let y is equal to e raised to ax plus b. Now differentiating with respect to x, we get here derivative of y with respect to x is equal to derivative of e raised to x plus b with respect to x. Now this is the composite function. So derivative of this function is e raised to x, derivative is e raised to x, but here x is replaced ax plus b. So again find the derivative of that function. So we get here derivative of y with respect to x is equal to e raised to ax plus b, and again a derivative of ax plus b with respect to x. Now here a is constant, take it outside, derivative of x with respect to x is 1, b is a constant, derivative of constant term is 0. So we get here derivative of y with respect to x is equal to e raised to ax plus b multiply a. Now this term we can write a raised to 1 multiply e raised to ax plus b. Now again a differentiating with respect to x, we get here derivative of dy by dx with respect to x is equal to a is a constant, take it outside, derivative of e raised to x plus b. Now again this is the composite function, so same procedure we can apply here. So d2y divided by dx square is equal to a multiply e raised to ax plus b multiply derivative of ax plus b. Again, the derivative of this term is only a. So, d2y divided by dx square is equal to a multiply e raised to ax plus b multiply a is equal to a square multiply e raised to ax plus b. Now, again, differentiating with respect to x, we get here derivative of d2y divided by dx square with respect to x is equal to a square is a constant, take it outside. Derivative of e raised to ax plus b with respect to x. Same procedure we can apply here. So, we get here d3y divided by dx cube is equal to a square multiply e raised to ax plus b multiply derivative of ax plus b with respect to x. Again, derivative of this term is only a. So, d3y divided by dx cube is equal to a square multiply e raised to ax plus b multiply a. So, this we can write a cube multiply e raised to ax plus b. So, we can find the differentiating this function in first time, second time, third time. Now, we observe here sine of every time is positive. And next observe here a power is increases means first time differentiate a power is 1, second time differentiate a power is 2, third time differentiate a power is 3, and this e raised to ax plus b is as it is every time. So therefore we general nth derivative is d raised to n of y divided by dx raised to n is equal to a raised to n multiply e raised to ax plus b. So, this is our final answer. Yeah, this is our nth derivative of given function. Now, next example is 1 upon ax plus b. So, let's start the solution. Let y is equal to 1 upon ax plus b. Now, differentiating with respect to x, we get here derivative of y with respect to x is equal to derivative of 1 upon ax plus b with respect to x. Now, this 1 upon ax plus b, we can write derivative of ax plus b raised to the power minus 1 with respect to x. Now, here, this is the x raised to n form. But this is the composite function because x raised to minus 1, this is the standard function. But x is replaced by ax plus b. So, first we find the derivative of x raised to n form and again find the derivative of ax plus b. So, here, derivative of y with respect to x is equal to minus 1 multiply ax plus b raised to the power minus 2 multiply derivative of ax plus b with respect to x. Now, so we get here derivative of y with respect to x is equal to minus 1 divided by derivative of this term is ax plus b raised to the power 2. 1 upon ax plus b raised to the power 2 multiply derivative of this term. Derivative of this term is a. So, this we can write here minus 1 raised to the power 1 multiply 1 multiply a divided by ax plus b raised to the power 2. Now again the differentiating with respect to x, we get here derivative of dy by dx with respect to x is equal to minus a, take it outside, derivative of 1 upon ax plus b whole square. This we can write derivative of ax plus b raised to the power minus 2 with respect to x. Again this is the x raised to n form. So, but this is the composite function. So, first find the derivative of x raised to n form and again find the derivative of ax plus b. So, we get here d2y divided by dx square is equal to minus a multiply minus 2 multiply 1 upon ax plus b raised to the power 3 and again a derivative of ax plus b with respect to x. We know that derivative of this term is only a. So, we get here minus multiply minus we get plus. So, d2y divided by dx square is equal to 2a divided 1 upon ax plus b raised to the power 3 multiply a. So, this we can write d2y divided by dx square is equal to 2a square divided by ax plus b whole cube is equal to this plus sign we can write here minus 1 raised to the power 2 multiply 2 multiply 1 multiply a square divided by ax plus b raised to the power 3. Now again a differentiating with respect to x. So derivative of d2y divided by dx square with respect to x is equal to 2a is constant, 2a square is constant, take it outside, derivative of 1 upon ax plus b raised to the power 3. So this we can write, we get here d3y divided by dx cube is equal to 2x square multiply minus 3 multiply 1 upon ax plus b raised to the power 4. This we can write ax plus b raised to the power 3. Again we find the derivative of x raised to n form, and again find the derivative of ax plus b, because this is a composite function. So again find the derivative of ax plus b with respect to x. Now derivative of this term is a. So we get here d3y divided by dx cube is equal to minus 1 multiply 2 multiply 3 multiply a cube, because derivative of this term is a. So a multiply a, which is a square. A multiply a square, we get a cube multiply 1 upon ax plus b raised to the power 4. So this we can write d3y divided by dx cube is equal to this minus sign, we can write minus 1 raised to the power 3 multiply 3 multiply 2 multiply 1. This is a coefficient. Multiply a cube divided by ax plus b raised to the power 4. So here if you differentiate first time, so answer is negative, ax plus b power is 2. So we observe that sign are alternative, plus minus plus minus. So in general, nth derivative is when you differentiate second time, this power is 3 means increases by 1. A power is 2 means as it is, whatever the derivative term, same power here means it is second time differentiate. So a power is also 2. If you third time differentiate, a power is also 3, and this power is increased by 1. So if you second time differentiate, this power is 3. Third time differentiate, this power is 4. So increases by 1. So in general, we can write this term in nth derivative is d raised to n of y divided by dx raised to n is equal to minus 1 raised to the power n multiply n multiply n minus 1 multiply dot 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 3 multiply 2 multiply 1 multiply a raised to n divided by ax plus b raised to the power n plus 1. Now this is known as n multiply n minus 1 multiply n minus 2 dot 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 3 dot 2 dot 1. This is a n factorial. So d n of y divided by dx raised to n is equal to minus 1 raised to the power n multiply n factorial multiply a raised to n divided by ax plus b raised to the power n plus 1. This is nth order derivative of given function. Now next example is sine ax plus b. Now this is a trigonometric function and angle is composite, which is ax plus b. So in short, this is a composite function. So first we find the derivative of sine, and again find the derivative of composite term, which is ax plus b. So let's start the solution. Let y is equal to sine inside the bracket ax plus b. Now differentiating with respect to x, we get here derivative of y with respect to x is equal to derivative of sine ax plus b with respect to x. So we know that derivative of sine, which is cos x. So dy by dx is equal to cos ax plus b. And again find the derivative of ax plus b with respect to x. So we know that derivative of ax plus b with respect to x, ax plus b derivative is a. So derivative of y with respect to x is equal to cos ax plus b multiply a. Now here this cos we can convert into sine term. So we can use here allied angle formula by help of this term convert into sine term. So derivative of y with respect to x is equal to a is as it is multiply sine pi by 2 plus ax plus b. So this cos we can convert into sine by using allied angle formula. Your angle is pi by 2 plus ax plus b, where pi by 2 means your ratio change, sine goes to cos goes to sine. Now this angle goes to the second quadrant, sine is positive. So here positive sine. So this we can write sine pi by 2 plus ax plus b. Now again differentiating with respect to x. So derivative of dy by dx with respect to x is equal to a is constant, derivative of sine pi by 2 plus ax plus b with respect to x. Again, this is a composite function. So sine derivative is cos. So d2y divided by dx square is equal to a multiplied cos pi by 2 plus ax plus b. And again, find the derivative of this term. So derivative of pi by 2 plus ax plus b with respect to x. So d2y divided by dx square is equal to a multiplied cos pi by 2 plus ax plus b multiply. Derivative of this constant is 0. Derivative of this term is a. So multiply a. So a multiply a, we get here a square multiply cos pi by 2 plus ax plus b. Now again, by using allied angle formula, this cos convert into sine. So d2y divided by dx square is equal to a square multiply sine pi by 2 plus all this angle. So pi by 2 plus pi by 2 plus ax plus b. Now we know that pi by 2 plus pi by 2, which is pi, but this we can write sine 2 pi by 2 plus ax plus b. Okay. Again, a differentiating v respect to x. So we get here derivative of d2y divided by dx square with respect to x is equal to a square is constant, take it outside. Derivative of sine inside the bracket 2 pi by 2 plus ax plus b with respect to x. We know that derivative, this is a composite function. So derivative of sine, which is cos, and again I find the derivative of this term. So we get here d3y divided by dx cube is equal to a square multiply cos inside the bracket 2 pi by 2 plus ax plus b as it is, angle is as it is, and again differentiating this term with respect to x. Now derivative of this term is 0 because this is a constant term, and derivative of ax plus b with respect to x is a only. So we get here d3y divided by dx cube is equal to a square multiply cos inside the bracket 2 pi by 2 plus ax plus b bracket complete multiply a, because derivative of that term is a. So a multiply a, we a multiply a square, we get a cube. So d3y divided by dx cube is equal to a cube multiply cos inside the bracket 2 pi by 2 plus ax plus b. Again, this cos convert into sine term by using allied angle formula, means this angle add by pi by 2. So d3y divided by dx cube is equal to a cube multiply sine inside the bracket pi by 2 plus 2 pi by 2 plus ax plus b. Now pi by 2 plus 2 pi by 2, that means 3 pi by 2. So d3y divided by dx cube is equal to a cube multiply sine inside the bracket 3 pi by 2 plus ax plus b. Now here observe that if you differentiate first time, a power is 1. Angle of sine is pi by 2 multiply 1. Now if you differentiate second time, that time angle is 2. Here pi by 2 multiply by 2 and a power is 2. Now if you differentiate third time, so a power is 3 and angle of this is pi by 2 multiply by 3 and other angle is as it is. So in general, nth derivative is dny divided by dx raised to n is equal to a raised to n, because whatever derivative, same power here. So nth derivative, so a raised to n multiply sine integral multiple by pi by 2 here n pi by 2 plus ax plus b. So this is nth order derivative of the given function. So this is our last example for this chapter. Now next chapter we can start application of derivative, which is based on again differentiation. Thank you.